Great, but totally stressed as always, about half an hour before it gone, but yeah, okay, thanks. Yeah.
How have you been spending the pandemic?
Oh my goodness, like everyone else, I guess, holed up. It's been bonkers, isn't it? I don't even know how we got through it, but we are. Yeah, same as everyone else, just holed up in the house and just going crazy.
Now, I think HRH Sleaze is a bit of a special kind of gig for you guys, isn't it?
Yeah, we've knocked it out so many times, and in the more recent years here in Sheffield, you know, at the Sleaze Festival, it's just been great every time. We've never had a bad gig, so I'm hoping tonight's not the, you know, the COVID isn't a bad gig, so fingers crossed, yeah.
I mean, you keep getting asked back, so you clearly like the crowd favourites.
I've never so thought of us as a pub band or a house band, but that's what we seem to be.
What can people expect from the set today? What can people expect from the set today?
Oh, well, we're doing the Berserk album, which is our most successful record. So we're doing it start to finish, not necessarily in sequence, but we've got some older songs in there as well for people. So, but yeah, I mean, it's maybe the Berserk record and a few other cherries put in there as well.
Okay, now I wanted to ask you a couple of questions about the older band. How did Stage Fright become Tigertailz? I mean, where did the name come from?
Do you know what? It was Pepsi's idea. Yeah, all the names came from him, and I'll never forget the first time he said Tigertailz. I was like, who's the band that, you know? And just as with always the way of him, he would, you know, convince you that it was a good idea, and so that's what we became. But I've never understood it, and I still don't. So.
The MTV videos were absolutely amazing. I mean, you know, what's your favourite story from that kind of time when the band was just, you know, kind of, I suppose it would have been fresh for you then, not, you know, like a new band, really.
I don't know, it was just, you were kind of remember bits of it vividly, but everything was so full on, like kind of happens at that point when you're young. And, I don't know, chaotic, I suppose. Everything was just like, do this, do that, you know, and you're just like, I don't know.
You didn't have time to think?
Not really.
I don't remember much from those days. I saw bands like LA Guns and I just can't remember it because, you know, so long ago, and also we were all drinking madly then as well.
Well, and that's always the thing that people come up to you and they say, oh, remember me, or, you know, remember that. I'm like, oh, you know, you're being rude, and you're not being rude, you just can't remember because of all those reasons, yeah.
Now, the band's been through a lot. I mean, obviously, we're missing Pepsi and the disagreements between the members, but I get the feeling that with this Tigertailz, you've moved on now. I mean, you're really in a different phase.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's like anything. A band has to work. I mean, it's just a business at the end of the day. You've got to be able to create anything. You've got to get on, you know, to a certain extent. And when there's problems, and then when you get older, you know what I mean? You become less tolerant, I suppose, you know. It's not life or death anymore, so it's going to work. And so when things don't work, you know, like a football club, just because somebody leaves or has to leave, you don't shut the football club down. You get somebody else in and re-energize yourself. I guess that's what we do. But no, this lineup's been solid for a few years now. So.
Yeah. And big highlights like 2014 Kiss Cruise.
Yeah. I mean, we've done some amazing gigs, you know, always have. But yeah, the memories have just been fantastic. So. Kiss, we've played them a couple of times, what we grew, yeah, it's been, yeah, amazing, absolutely.
Are you planning to tour or do any more gigs?
I wouldn't hold your breath, but maybe, yeah, I mean, it takes a lot to kind of get us all, it takes a lot, but we're writing, I mean, that's the one thing, writing new songs, so, you know, we can't do more than that, and it'll happen.
Yeah, because it's not that long since the last new album. I mean, it's a few years, but it's not that long. It's not like in ancient history. So, I mean, is there any more new music on its way?
Yeah. I mean, I'm writing stuff at the moment, so definitely into that. And that's a big step up, you know, when you start writing again. But at the end of the day, it's all about the music. If you're in a band, you write songs, you make music, you release it, you play gigs. To me, that's what a band is. So you've got to have that material, you know. So, yeah, we're doing that.
Are you doing any other projects yourself? Anything else?
Well, that's the bit I'm writing. I'm writing some stuff that maybe isn't necessarily Tails stuff. So I'll see how it goes. Maybe, I don't know, but you know, kind of, I've been in this band so long, I don't know how to be in any other band. That's what it comes down.
No, it's very common, even with photographers, to get hearing loss from hearing so much loud music.
Yeah.
Now, you did have some problems, but I heard that you recovered from them. Is that right?
Well, not recovered. You just learn to live with it and deal with it and work it. sorted out, and so now I've got, I've got severe hearing loss, really, and my tinnitus problems. I've worked that out with hearing aids and things, but I'm live, you know, we're using in-ear monitors now, which is the way to go. But once it's gone, it's gone. So it's a message, you know, a message to any, a warning to any musician, take care of your ears, because once it's gone, it's gone.
Yeah, well, we didn't. I mean, I used to go real close with the Osborne monitors and stuff. We just didn't worry about it, did we? What's next for the band?
Playing this gig tonight.
After this gig.
Well, we've got another Hard Rock Ale in 2 months, and then we've got a festival next year in France, so, you know, there's still stuff going on.
I just wanted to tell you before we go, I studied law at Oxford, right, and I was madly into Tigertailz. And the Don, I mean, he was a specialist in ancient Roman law. And